Now on Channel 4, something truly momentous. The 1,000th edition of Big Breakfast.
These are the main stories on Thursday, the 25th of July. It's official, smoking causes cot death. Another win makes it triple gold for Ireland's Michelle. Why Wallace and Gromit are right up your street. Smoking is today revealed as the sinister killer responsible for most of the 500 cot deaths in Britain each year. The shock new findings back up what campaigners have always believed. Scientists now say cigarettes kill 7 British babies every week, and the government is backing them with a massive health campaign urging parents to give kids a smoke-free zone. Divers searching the wreckage of the crashed TWA jet in New York have found both black boxes, the flight data and cockpit voice recorders. Recovery teams are now bringing them to the surface, the first step towards ending the mystery surrounding the tragic end of Flight 800. Relatives of the boy abandoned in a park are pleading for his mother to phone home. Julie Lane rang police to check that Stephen was okay, but she hung up. Foster parents are currently taking care of the 4-year-old. Buckingham Palace is denying rumours of a rift with the BBC after ending its monopoly on the Queen's Christmas speech. A royal spokesman denied any connection between the move and Diana's panorama interview that infuriated the palace. Production of the annual message will alternate with ITV. 2 streets in Bristol are being named after film heroes Wallace and Gromit. A new housing development in the city is to include Wallace Walk and Gromit Grove in tribute to Oscar-winning animator Nick Park, the Plasticine Pears creator. Irish swimmer Michelle Smith has stunned Atlanta by winning her 3rd Olympic gold. She took the 200 metres individual medley after lying in 4th place just 50 metres from home. Michelle couldn't believe it.
Oh, it seems like a dream at this point in time. I think I'm living in a dream at the moment. I think I'll only believe it after the swimming is over.
The stunning performance sparked a night of celebration in local Irish pubs, but some fans are still furious at American allegations of illegal drug use.
And now I sincerely hope that the United States media will give her the credit she deserves.
But it was bad news for Britain's Nick Gillingham. The 29-year-old missed out on a third Olympic medal, finishing fourth in the 200 metres breaststroke. He's now quitting the sport. He won bronze in Barcelona and silver in Seoul. After day five of the Olympics, Russia are back on top, one gold ahead of the US, with France filling third place. And thanks to Michelle Smith, the Irish are showing off three golds. Formula One team Williams-Renault are dismissing reports that they'll sack Damon Hill at the end of the season. He leads the championship by 15 points after winning 6 out of 10 races. Frank Williams has reportedly approached Heinz Harald Frentzen to replace him. Now the weather, warm and sunny with cool light winds in England and Wales, but Scotland and Northern Ireland will start misty with rain due later, and temperatures are up on yesterday, hitting 23 degrees in the southeast. In yesterday's Big Breakfast News, we told you how the Mardi Gras bomber is targeting Sainsbury's with blackmail threats. We also said that Tesco stores have been targeted. We now know that this isn't true, and so today we're happy to correct it. 7:06, we're back at 7:20. I hope we're back to Keith and Zoe.
Debbie and Dave, thank you very much.
Cheers.
I have never been so nervous in the whole of my life.
I want to do it again.
Well, I was going to say, some of the things I've done on TV, I've abseiled, jumped off mountaintops, a whole host of things.
Were you scared?
I've never been so scared in the whole of my life.
And the land was out. I was so scared. Look at this.
It's our first show. It's the 25th of July. And Matt, our cameraman, is telling me to slow down. Have Zoe and I got a show for you this morning. It is the biggest and the best Big Breakfast. Look at this. We have got 1,000 cameras to give away because on the Big Breakfast, we've been asking you to keep a note of the phone number. You won't see the number this morning, but if you can remember it, you could win one of these amazing cameras. And they talk to you.
They talk to you. Look. When you take a photograph, they talk to you. Ready, listen? Oh.
Go on, let me press one.
There we go. 1,000 show. Cheese. That was it.
You can win one of these if you didn't remember our Big Breakfast number. I say we've got 1,000 cameras to give away and a special prize to the 1,000th caller this morning is a trip to the States. We have a whole host of celebrities ready to take your calls. And this is the prize that you could win.
You'll be blown away by the prize we're offering to our 1,000th caller this morning.
It's starting to turn.
If you are that lucky person, you'll be twisting your way to Iowa in the USA.
Where I can't see
you
it.
You will.
When the box office smash Twister was filmed.
Great. So if you like the sound of that, you could actually win a trip to the States this morning. But if you're one of the callers on the line, you can win this, the Polaroid 636 camera. It could be yours if by just simply giving us a call. Our number for you this morning, you've got the phone card. Claire Rock is with us. Hey, is 0181 95.
Query.
We've got Nick, we've got Tristan, we've got Nino, we've got Vicky, we've got Joanne, we've got Emma, we've got Don, and we've got Flair. And even more stars popping in this morning.
But right now, of course, on our 1,000 show, it is time to shout, where are you, Richard, Vanessa and Danny?
Yes, we are here. 1,000 shows. Can't go wrong with that, really, can you? 1,000 shows. And today we are in Witham in Essex. Just take a look at that. 1,000 shows. If you remember, a little while back, we did an offer out to all the viewers of the Big Breakfast. We said, write in if you want the Big Breakfast to come to your home. Well, these are the lucky winners. They're the Kettridge Jeffreys. It's a huge family. Look, it's got the Bunting. All right, guys, up there. Into the hallway we go now. Kettridge Jeffreys. It's like the Brady Bunch. They've got 9 kids. Incredible. Loads of people around today, including we've got Gabrielle there. She's going to be performing later on. All right, Gabrielle? Having a nice cup of tea, yeah? Put your feet up, love. All right, then. And out here, we've got... Look at this. This is incredible. This is our gallery today. These are all the guys there in the shed here.
Morning,
it's an amazing feat, an incredible achievement. This is Peter Johnson, our technical director. A bit like having the chairman of British Gas come to read your meter. And look, here, mate. It's 10p for you. Stick it in there. All right. Thanks very much. Excellent. All right, let's move through now. Through the hallway, upstairs. Loads of stuff going on today. All the family are scattered in and around the house. Up here, we have Vanessa. Vanessa, hi. The guys with the mum and dad of the family. Hiya, Vanessa, and you're interviewing a top celebrity guest later on.
Cavorting with a very, very famous mystery celebrity on this very bed.
Looking forward to it. And over here, I believe, in this very room, I think we've got our very own Danny Minogue. Danny, where's she gone? Oh, she's in the Danny, what on earth are you doing
Danny,
in the shower?
I
came over all funny then seeing you in the shower. Very exciting.
Oh, no,
indeed. Danny Minogue
now,
here. I wasn't indeed. Very good. Danny Minogue, Vanessa, Gabrielle, all going on here today. But first, let's meet the family who's let us into their house.
With the Kittredge Jeffries from Witham in Essex.
Hi, I'm Pauline, mum of the family, and believe me, what a whole lot of family. There's Ryan, Lauren, Kyle, Kelly, Jamie, Katie, Stefan, and Louise, not forgetting baby Paige and my wonderful husband Kev. Yes, that's 9 kids in all, count them. Ryan's the ladies' man with a taste for kebabs. Lauren likes making cakes and dancing to disco. Kyle lives for football and dies when I kiss him in front of his mates. Kelly misses take that and has a certificate for being brave in hospital. Jamie is only happy sleeping in his hat. Katie loves a boyfriend and is always in a twirl. Stefan spends more time with fish than he does with the family. Louise likes to stick things together. And little Paige looks cute and loves feet. On top of all that, there's my husband Kev, who's fitness mad and dreams of life in a big screen blockbuster. And me, a professional mum who hates ironing and loves music more than anything. All in all, we're the biggest big breakfast family in the world ever. Because if there's one thing we are, it's large!
Hi, here we are on the bed with Pauline, Kevin and Paige. Hi, Paige. She's eating her name badge the whole time. That's what she's been doing most of the morning. She had a good cup of tea when she woke up. I've never seen anyone drink tea like that. And what we're going to do is try and get to know you even better by looking at just a few of your favourite things. So what have you chosen, Pauline?
Right, well, I've actually got some concert tickets and some programmes.
George Benson at the Chelmsford Spectacular. I had George Benson on the bed.
Oh, it's excellent.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, excellent.
And here's old Rod Stewart. Is he one of your...
Yeah, he's one of my favourites. I went to see him a few years ago and we had such a good time.
And do you think he's sexy?
I do.
You do. Who else have we got under here?
Curtis Stein.
Oh, yes.
And I went to see Take That with Kelly.
Did you? And did you groove on down or did you feel a bit...
Did
you?
Of course I did.
Which was your fave?
Actually, I like them all, but Howard's got ever such a cute bum.
You like Howard's bum? Who do you think's going to sort of win in the Robbie versus Mark debate?
Probably
Robbie. Do you? Is he your favourite?
Yeah. Well, he's chosen a good record.
True. Very true. Now, Kevin, what have you chosen as your...
Kelly's a picture. It's a starting left one, yeah. It's a memorabilia since I was 14.
Really, Clint Eastwoodiana. I'm sure that's the formal term for it.
Clint Eastwoodiana.
What is it about Clint that really appeals?
Just all the films, everything.
Could it be that you look a little like him now? Rugged, wind-blown, Mayor of Carmel look?
I wish.
And if you won the lottery, what would you do with the money?
I'd go to America, definitely.
Would you?
Kind of get a Carmel.
And just hang out with Clint? Yeah. What do you think of his new bride? A bit too young.
Young, especially for me. Keeps him young, so I suppose.
So we're not going to be trading in Pauline for a younger model. But just tell me, what has Paige chosen as her object of desire?
Right, she's got a book, and there is a shoe.
There's a shoe somewhere on this, but she's probably eaten it though.
Oh,
she's a bit of a she's a shoe buyer.
She's a shoe freak.
Do you like to say shoe, Paige? Shoe. She said duck before. It was excellent. And now it's time to ask, where are you, Danny?
I'm in the bedroom, of course, with the boys. That'd have to be it, wouldn't it? There's a party going on outside, but there's a party going on inside the house. And I'm asking the boys, what is your favourite object of desire? And I'm going to start with Ryan. Now, Ryan, what's your favourite object?
Football.
Football, and what do you have here?
A football medal.
And did you win this?
Yes.
With the team?
Yeah.
And was that, like, the best moment? Or is the big breakfast coming to your house the best moment?
Yeah.
Good, good. That was the right answer.
Yeah.
Okay, Jamie, say hi.
Ow.
What's your favourite object of desire?
My bulldog.
Your bulldog, and why would that be?
Because I like dogs.
Yeah, and are you planning to get a bulldog?
Yeah,
Where would it fit in the house?
In my bedroom.
In your bedroom. Do the other boys agree with that?
Good answer.
The other boys agree with that?
Yeah.
You can have a bulldog in here. Kyle, what is your object of desire?
Well, I would go to a Tottenham football match.
Show everyone there.
My point. See Tottenham in Manchester City.
I know.
And we won.
This
one-nil.
Much about football. But you've got to show us who's this over there to your right.
Teddy Sheridan. My favourite
player. And now on to Stefan. What is your object of desire?
My fishing box.
Your fishing box. Better than girls.
Yeah.
Tell me, what does a fish have that a girl doesn't have?
Don't know.
I've got to stick with the fishing. Really. Now, guys, remember I said you're all going to help me with this bit? It's time to shout, Wayne Richard!
I'm with the girls in Kelly's bedroom, actually. Very exciting indeed. I'm on the bed with the girls. We've got Kelly here, and we've got Louise, and we've got Lauren, and we've got Katie. All right, girls? There's just so many people here in this family. Okay, Kelly, you brought along an item. Show us what you've got.
I've got my take that photo. I'm quite a sad individual, really.
Let's have a look at them very quickly.
There's my one of Robbie.
Is this at a concert you went to, yeah?
No, it was at a nightclub.
Did you join Chatty Island?
No, we didn't. I was quite disappointed.
So who do you prefer then? Do you prefer Robbie or do you prefer Gary?
I've got a bit of a crush on Robbie. Gary's cool too.
He's doing all right, isn't he?
Yeah, he's still cool too, but I do prefer Rob.
All right, and Kelly, and we've got Louise here. Now, what's your object, Louise? What is it, Mr. Blobby? And what's he dressed in here? What's that?
It used to be my brother's clothes.
This is your brother's clothes, is it? Is your brother happy about that?
When he was a baby.
When he was a little baby. He was a very small baby, wasn't he? He was premature, wasn't he? Is that right?
Yeah, he was only £4 something, I think.
Blimey. And look at that. Well, it doesn't go to waste, anyway. It's been passed down the generations to Mr. Blobby. That's good. And we've got Lauren here. Now, what have you brought along, Lauren?
I've brought my oldest teddy.
Your oldest teddy? What's his name? Teddy,
Rainbow.
By any chance? Rainbow. Oh, I can see why. It's got all those colours on there. And what's this outfit you got on here? Because that's very nice.
It's my disco clothes.
Oh, you go disco dancing, do you? Do you enjoy it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good. Well, perhaps we'll have a bit of a fling outside, you know, later. A bit of a bop. Gabrielle's here. She'll be performing later. And we've got Katie here. What's your object, Katie?
My cat. This is my oldest favourite teddy bear.
Yeah, I've seen better days, I'd have thought, to be honest. Have a bit of an accent outside.
Yeah.
Good stuff. What's his name?
Brown Puss.
Something very embarrassing I want to tell you, actually. Your mum said that you can't go anywhere without taking this with you. Is this true?
No, that used to be true, but I'm all right now. I can sleep without it now.
Yeah, I believe it, Katie. Do you want to just hold on to that? All right, there we go. All right, coming up later, we've got Gabrielle, we've got a mystery guest, we've got a street party in Witham in Essex. That's it from this house. It's back to the house.
Hey, thank you. I wonder who that mystery guest is.
I think I might know.
Fancy having the Big Breakfast crew in your house. Muddy boots, asking for bacon sandwiches and coffee all the time.
It's a great atmosphere here.
It is. Look at this.
You hear this for roaring? It's all our telephone answers, because of course you could win yourself one of these cameras, and if you are our 1,000th caller of the day, you could win yourself a trip to America.
Yeah, I are, in fact. Okay, and we also have been asking you to write in with your favourite moments of the Big Breakfast, and Lucy Walker from Manchester, this is her favourite moment. Take a look at this.
number one punk album, 47 punk rock classics on one blistering double album, including The Stranglers, Sham 69 and The Buzzcocks, The Jam and Susie and the Banshees, The Sex Pistols, then The Undertones. The number one punk album, out now on double CD and cassette.
Hi, Letitia Dean here, and I just want to say congratulations, Big Breakfast, on your 1,000th show.
Hey, hey! First question of the day is what Madeline... Oh! Am I right, or am I wrong in saying what mad lies you were told when you were a little boy? My mum used to tell me that if you ever take things too far, you trip over on television, but I never believed her.
Leo calls a spit from work, he says,
that was a major stumble.
Do it. That was only Taylor's favourite moment, and he's from where are you, Dartford? So thanks very much for writing in and letting us know about that, Andy. You're probably wondering why this siren is here. That siren will go off when we get our 1,000th caller this morning, and if you are that 1,000th caller, you can actually win a trip to the States this morning. It's a cracking show. Zig and Zag will be in the box room with Upside Down at 7:23. Baywatch's Alexandra Paul in the house, and she'll be saying hello to fellow Baywatch heartthrob Jason Simmons at 7:45.
And also, at 7:55, I will be in the kitchen with E17. Yo! Performing their top new single, Someone to Love. And then also at 7:27 and 7:45, Julian Telford and Julia Carling will be taking a dip into our pit of 1,000 old balls. More of that later.
All right, bit of fate for them coming up a little bit later on. But right now for us, 7:21's the time. He's Pete Smith, Big Breakfast News and Weather.
Card stories. Scientists say cigarette smoke is the silent killer behind most of Britain's 500 cot deaths each year. A two-year study shows that two-thirds of the tiny victims could be saved if they were given a smoke-free environment. Relatives of the toddler abandoned in Bournemouth are pleading for his mother to call. Four-year-old Stephen Lane was found in a park. His mum, Julie, called police to check on him but hung up. Hugh Grant and Liz Hurley's new Hollywood home isn't the hideaway they hoped it would be. The golden couple are insisting the apartment is very romantic, despite the paparazzi already staking it out, and the fact that it's just a short walk from where Hugh got busted with Divine Brown. Michelle Smith has taken another Olympic gold. The Irish swimmer won the 200 metres individual medley to claim her third crown in Atlanta. Tomorrow she competes in the 200 metres butterfly, her strongest event. Now the weather, a warm sunny day in England and Wales with plenty of cool breezes, but expect more rain over Scotland and Northern Ireland. Temperatures are climbing slightly to an average of 21 degrees centigrade. 7:22, we're back at 7:40. Here's Keith and Zoe.
Thanks, Pete. Bit of a milestone for Pete as well. You and Pete have been here right since the beginning.
Well, I was here just after 6 months after. Yeah, 6 months onto the show, but Pete has been here from the very first day.
And
he hasn't aged a bit. And Jerry,
John,
the cameraman.
John and Jerry, they've been here for all their time. Now, all morning, we are giving away some top prizes. Okay, we're giving away 1,000 Polaroid 636 cameras to everyone who calls up. And I'm just going to ask Tristan here. Tristan, how many calls have we had so far?
We've had 125. Calls.
Yeah, 25 calls. It's quite a long way to go. And the 1,000th caller, very, very exciting, will win themselves a trip to America.
But we're being very mean this morning because we're not giving out our phone number because we asked you all week to remember it. But we'll give you the first few digits and just go like this. Donna, have you got the card? Donna. 0818 985 query. You can win yourself
you
a camera.
You should know that number if you are an ardent fan.
And if you're the 1,000th caller, you can win a trip to the States. OK, 7:23 is the time. Let's go upstairs to the crunch.
Zig, don't touch that!
The crunch.
What the hell? No! Hi guys, how are you doing?
Okay.
Cool. Excellent. So what have you been up to? What have you been up to?
Road shows.
Road shows?
Yeah. Rehearsing for our tour.
Oh, wow. Great.
excellent, and the album and everything. It's just everything. Brilliant. It's all right. It's all happening this summer.
It is.
Turning upside down for upside down.
I like it. Zeke. You can quote him on that if you want.
Yeah.
That is a good quote, Zeke.
Cool. Now, Zeke, thanks. I'll end up on myself as well.
I'm sure that the gentleman from upside down would be interested in maybe winning 1,000. Let me hear Zeke say it again. 1,000 pop star prizes.
Well, as it is, as it is the 1,000 show, we are feeling pretty generous.
We are.
And we are going to give you the chance to win 1,000 top star prizes. Yes, indeed. Tell them what they've got to do, Zeke.
Indeed, what you have to do is identify 3 top crunch guests held upside down.
Get it?
By Mad Dog Orford. Down our lucky, or indeed not so lucky, viewer street. Mad Dog, are you there?
Come in, Mad Dog.
I am here.
Yeah, now,
I'm here, boys.
Richie, can you hold upside down our first firm crunch favourite?
Get on with it, Zay.
Thank you.
There you go, that's
Tony
Kerr. Who is it?
Tony Kerr.
Yes!
Woo!
It is!
Yes,
it is. Our favourite uncle.
Uncle Tone. It's Uncle Tone.
Okay,
Uncle
correct.
Tone.
Can you identify the next Crunch favourite, please?
Princess
Diana. Close, though.
It is Pamela Anderson, yes.
And finally, can you identify this final Crunch favourite, please?
This is for 1,000
prizes. That's our Paula, that is.
Yes, it is.
It is our
straight away. That's unbelievable. Can we have the prize, please? The prizes!
Hundreds and thousands.
Yes! Oh. Over 1,000 very small star prizes.
In fact, you know what? There's probably more than 1,000 in here.
Congratulations.
Should we count them?
There you go, John.
You can count them, actually.
Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, upside down here, celebrating.
Upside down!
Big breakfast. This is so excellent.
Cool.
The question about the clip is, what the Billy Bonkers happens next?
Oh, remember, wait, don't Richard.
It's upside
down. See you,
down.
Richard. See ya.
Give me the love you, give me the love you, give me non-stop. The lyrics up, my flow, we're right from the top. The million things I can know, we're gone on top.
The girls, they gotta love me. The girls, they gotta love me. The girls, they gotta love me.
Disaster. Look at my dandruff.
What you need is Head and Shoulders. It's the business look.
In tests, it shifts dandruff so much faster that even after another chance, the other one still hasn't caught up with Head and Shoulders.
See? No dandruff.
And it looks great. Thanks.
Don't forget your hat.
Who needs it?
Fastest ever Head and Shoulders. Forget dandruff. Have beautiful hair.
Happy 1,000th birthday, Big Breakfast.
And Mary, hold your hand. You feel so grand. Your heart starts beating like a big brass band. Lily! Oh, it's a jolly holiday with Mary. No wonder that it's Mary that we're all.
You gonna come back down or what?
Oh, I'm so pleased. Hello. I'm so pleased that one was chosen. Lily in action there. And that was suggested by Martin Slater from Morecambe. That was his favourite moment from the 3rd of May, 1996. Thank you very much, Martin. OK, it's our 1,000th show. And for today, and today only, we're playing a brand new competition. Yes, it goes like this. Hit it.
Quiz of 1,000 old balls. Quiz of 1,000 old
Nice to see you. Hey, you've been basking in the sun.
Yeah,
here.
Orlando.
You
Orlando.
Oh, you're out.
Lovely. Yeah, it was brilliant. Yeah. Met Goofy, Minnie, Mickey Mouse. I loved it.
No, I'm not talking about the cast. Talking about you.
Yeah.
Hey, we've got a challenge for you this morning. This is our brand new competition for one day only. 1,000 balls in there, right? They're all numbered.
All right.
Now, all you've got to do, right, is dance in there. When the music stops, you pick a ball. On that ball is a very important number, which corresponds to a number that I've got in the filing cabinet. If my card's in there, we have a fate, a little forfeit for you to have a go at this morning. So, Gillian, can I wish you the best of luck?
Thanks.
A little
so
peck
much.
On the chin. Showbiz pat on the back.
Is this goodbye? Is this yours?
No, it could be. It could be the end of a career.
Yeah,
all right, good luck to you. When the music stops, give me a numbered ball. On your marks, get set, Gillian Tarfel, go! Woo! And there she goes. There's 1,000 balls in there. There's 1,000 numbers on them. Okay, the music stopped. Give me a ball with a number on. Ball with a number on. Okay, number 42. You all right, Gillian?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay,
I'll
number 42.
Right.
It's going to the old filing cabinet. thank you very much, Matt. Where are we? Number 40, 21, 15. No, hang on, we're going for genuine stuff here. Number 42. Okay, let's have a look for you, Gillian. Could you read that out, please? No, that's not mine. There's nothing on that one. Let me try another one. No, there's nothing on that one either. I'll tell you what. Should we give her a forfeit off the card?
Yes!
Thanks
a lot.
Okay. Here comes the forfeit for you. Oh, gosh. It's a tough one. I need my jacket, please. Thank you very much. Because I am the ice cream vendor.
For anyone.
Look, thank you very much. Okay, now look, we have two ice lollies here for you. Then we're going to do a consumer test for you, right?
All right.
You've got 10 seconds to suck on those lollies, right?
Oh,
and
God.
Tell us.
I wonder who gave you this one today.
Tell us which has the most exciting flavour. But you've only got 10 seconds and your time starts now.
Go on, Gillian.
Get stuck in.
Go on, Gillian.
Okay, get down on it. Go on, love. Go on, away we go. Okay, it's an A1 consumer test. You haven't got much time left. You've got to suck out as much flavour as you possibly can. You've got 5 seconds. Okay. We'll give her another 5 seconds. Because we're all enjoying this one. Hold it there. Okay, is it this one or is it this one? Tried and tested.
Well, I might be a bit of a say, but I think it's that one.
Okay, lovely.
I
give
like
her a big
one.
Round of applause. Yeah. 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 What a star. Okay. It's our fashion show. He's something else to suck on. The Crunch with Zig and Zag.
Zig, don't touch that!
The Crunch.
Yes! Yes!
Hello!
Do you know what's unbelievable?
Hello!
I keep going on about it, but it is incredible.
Yeah.
1,000 shows!
It is.
Zig, if you could actually calculate...
Stop throwing stuff at me!
Zig, it's a party they're supposed to.
Give me my eye!
Zig.
Stop throwing...
Zig, we've done 1,000 crunches. Part ones. Zig, you
listening? Stop throwing... Get off!
Zig, you listening? We've done 1,000 crunches part ones.
Yeah.
1,000 crunches part twos.
Yeah.
We've done some, you know... Summer and Christmas, we've done part threes. Summer and Christmas, we've done part threes.
Yep.
Then there's like trails after the show. Yep. I mean, we've done. We've done thousands,
stop.
Literally thousands
Damn it,
of
stop
things.
Stop throwing stuff at me!
Stop it!
Now!
Oh, give it a rest for a moment. Calm down. Because actually, I'm in a bit of a reflective mood at the moment, Zig.
Yeah.
And I've been asked by the Big Breakfast team what were my favourite three moments.
And did they ask what my favourite things could be as well?
No, they didn't ask that.
Well,
Zig.
Because I have answered. No.
No, Zig. Well, maybe. Let me think about it. My favourite three moments. I mean, it's been a hard decision, and these are just like the tip of the iceberg. But I think you, the viewers, are going to have a little treat now, as myself and my brother look back at 1,000 Big Breakfasts. Now, my favourite one, or one of my favourites, was going to Texas with Aerosmith. They are blooming cool. Check this out.
Whoa!
Aerosmith rock! They're cool. Oh, it's brilliant, Zig. Hey, do you know what else I love? loved. Well, of course I would. I mean, everyone did. Auntie Pammy Anderson came in with that husband bloke of hers. Wasn't too pushed on him, but she was cool for a game of go for a pee. You were. And Paula's just a signed autograph.
Oh, thank you.
Look at that.
Yes,
Seek.
Thank you.
We can put
this
by our bed, baby. Look, we have a signed autograph.
All right.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's gorgeous.
Can I just see?
It's a little revealing.
Where am I?
But it's clothed. I want a naked picture.
And moving swiftly along. Wow, she was cool.
And wait, when can I do my three? My three favorites?
I don't think so, Ziggy.
But just three.
Yes. No, Zig, we'll think about it. We're thinking about it, aren't we? We're thinking. We haven't decided. My other favourite, this is my third one, was of course...
Where do babies come from?
Not now, Zig. Was of course Uncle Tony Curtis in Cannes. He was cool.
Uncle Tony, you're the best!
You know, Zag, I've really got to like you guys.
Thanks, cool. Uncle Tony.
Would you call me Zug from now on?
Sure.
You are now
Zig,
known
Zag,
as Zug.
And Zug.
Yes. Cool!
Well, okay, it's my three
He's
now.
He's our big old uncle. What,
Can
no,
I do
no,
my,
Zig,
no, I want to do my no. three!
Do you want to hear Zig's three favourite moments?
Oh, please! Please!
No,
oh,
are you sure?
Please. Well, my favourite one was when our uncle and Danny Baker was in.
Oh, yeah.
And way back in the bathroom days.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and remember we used to have that very, very special train. The very special train.
Let's take a look
Watch
at
this.
It now. Oh, no, it's an earthquake! Oh!
Exciting world of train spotting. You know, when we started this piece, we thought we're never going to be able to flesh that out.
No, look! Everybody, it's Annika Wright! She's swimming to the surface! Annika!
There's a killer sandwich! It's going to eat her!
Run for your lives! It's Annika Wright's gums!
I've forgotten about that one completely.
Yeah, I know.
Good one.
Yeah, and another one, right?
Yeah,
another
no,
one. This is another one of my favourite ones, right?
Yeah,
and this is one with the Ginger Winger. Again, way back in the bathroom
days. Way back in the halcyon days.
And if you're the type of person who likes to inhale a good stink, you'll enjoy
not that clip.
This.
Not that clip.
Yeah.
No,
that's disgusting!
Did he do room? Prince Evans did a room!
He was always doing that.
What's your last one?
Whatever happened to him?
Keep it clean.
Got too big for his boots.
Anyway!
Pardon?
Zig!
Anyway!
Final one!
Yes, the final one,
your
right? The final
moment.
One. And you remember Ascot Day?
Yeah?
Remember Ascot Day? Remember that lady who had that problem?
Oh no.
Yeah.
Zig, no!
Watch this!
No!
Watch it! Move! Watch it! Roll it!
If you like the video,
yeah?
If you could give us a nice nice thumbs up.
Right. Thumbs up?
Yeah.
Who did that? Shelly! Really? A nice thumbs up. And if you don't like it, thumbs up. I warned you not to get rude.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Well, that's all the time we have for looking back a thousand big breakfasts.
It's been great, because we've just been such good buddies and everything.
Yeah.
I mean, thanks for watching.
Thanks for watching. And Zig.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you think I should ask the boys what their favourite moment was?
Yeah.
Boys, what was your favourite moment?
Patra!
Patra? Oh, God, blimey.
Well, not that lady with the wobbly bottom.
Yes, her with the wobbly bottom. Roll it!
I'm gonna give you a little bit of the bumper, right?
Yeah, okay, the bump. Okay,
so I have to sing, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Pull up the my bumper, watch me.
Oh my gosh! Hey!
Ay, ay, ay! Woo! Oh, well, listen, that's all the time we've got for Zeke.
Yeah?
We have 1,000 shows.
Yay!
It's just been brilliant. It's going to be... The
Get
fun
off!
Will continue. We've got
Stop
Upside Down coming up later
me.
On.
You're now, frightening me with those clip. Explosions.
What the 1,000th show happens next? Remember, don't phone. It's 1,000 big breakfasts. Woo!
Russell Grant. Show us your pants! 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 Pants!
Delighted. Pants, 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 pants,
pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants, pants,
Nesquik cereal. Delicious Nesquik chocolate taste.
Nesquik cereal, Nesquik taste from the first bite to the last drop.
And now from Disney's The Hunchback of Notre Dame, free figurines in special packs of Nesquik cereal.
Hoots, mum, there's juice. Loose, have it this house. Set the juice loose!
percent off many Power Rangers and selected big brands at the Woolworths Toy Sale. Get there quick.
During the summer, I'm often asked how to protect hair from damage. Well, I recommend Pantene, the hair that looks so healthy, it shines.
Sparkling spring water, exotic fruit juices, the taste of Rio.
Samba!
It's 5,740 miles away from any other drink.
Play squads!
I've built the best squad I can think of.
Find myself another squad player,
then muller him.
Squads, the Premier League card game you play to win.
Hi, I'm Robbie Williams, and a big congratulation goes out to The Big Breakfast, the one and only Big Breakfast, on their 1,000th show.
From Umesh Kumar from St Albans. That was his favourite. And that was the 23rd of December 1994. Yeah. You were so good, King.
Oh, thank you. Isn't it nice having all your friends round on the 1,000th edition, because they can do all the next bits. Go on, tell them what's coming up, Julie.
Oh, thanks very much. Still to come, Baywatch's Alexander Paul and Asmont Dantzscher's Take That. And Jason Simmons will be here at 7.45. Vanessa will be talking to Frank Bruno about his controversial boxing. Return to boxing. And at 7.55, East 17 performing their sensational new single, In the Kitchen.
Julia, come on!
Yes! Brian,
you have your lolly back now.
I've been here for nearly all of those 1,000 shows. It's over to Pete Smith for the Big Breakfast News.
Oh, lovely. I like it.
Top stories. Cigarette smoke is to blame for most of Britain's 500 cot deaths each year. A two-year government study has nailed the lie that there's no link between smoking and the deaths of 10 babies every week. Divers have located both black boxes belonging to TWA Flight 800. The flight data and cockpit voice recorders are now being brought to the surface of the Atlantic. It's hoped they'll solve the mystery of the ill-fated jumbo. The world's first ever test tube baby is celebrating her 18th birthday. Since Louise Brown's historic birth, the techniques that created her have been repeated successfully 150,000 times across the globe. Louise is now training to be a nanny. Irish Wonder Woman Michelle Smith has clinched another Olympic title. The 26-year-old shrugged off a back injury to win the 200 metres individual medley, her third gold medal. Tomorrow she competes in her strongest event, the 200 metres butterfly. Now the weather, a warm sunny day in England and Wales with plenty of cool breezes, but expect more rain over Scotland and Northern Ireland. Temperatures are climbing slightly to an average of 21 degrees centigrade. 7.43, we're back at 8. It's back to the house.
Cheers, Peter. The lines are busy this morning. Our celebrity guest stars are on the phone. Nina, how's it going?
It's going really well.
1-4-1-1.
Oh, Chris, hello. Hello, Mrs. Kendricks.
Morning.
Where are you phoning from?
What's your name?
Hello, Richard. Ian Clapton, great, nice to speak to you. Okay, we've got Dave down here. Look, Nick is back with us.
Hello, Liz. Richard, you're on. Do you want to say a word at the Big Breakfast?
Go on, mate. Who is it?
It's Richard.
Hi, Richard, how you doing? Nice to speak to you. Okay.
He wants to win a camera.
We're looking for he's got a camera for just for phoning in. Yeah, we're looking for our 1,000th caller this morning who could win a trip to the States. To date, we've had 415 so far.
Not even halfway yet.
I know.
Good for you. Keep
415 callers have actually got a Polaroid 636 camera. Good
they
news.
Have indeed. And the number to ring, of course, is a slight reminder here. 0181 985
Query. You must remember
What are those four other digits? What are those four other digits? If you know them,
you can win a camera.
It's our 1,000th edition. They're out and about, aren't they?
They're out and about. They're at the Ketteridge's house. We're going to go all the way to Essex. It's time to show. Where are you? Vanessa, Danny and Richard.
And Richard!
In Essex for the 1,000th show, we've come to somebody's house to do the show here today. This is Kevin, and this is Pauline, and the Ketteridge Jeffers and our mum and dad, and we've got the whole family here as well. And we've got little Paige, meet little Paige, and there she is. There's little Paige, and there's Vanessa as well. Vanessa, she's not part of the family, she's just pitching along with her. How's it all going then, guys?
Hectic.
Did you ever believe this would happen?
No way.
And is it, how does it feel to have all these people in your front garden?
Nervous. Lost for words.
Are you videoing it?
Good.
Well, that's the main thing. How about you, Pauline? Are you enjoying it?
Great.
Excellent. Well, we've got a bit of a mystery guest turning up now. When I say a mystery guest, I mean a big, top, special guest. He's going to pitch up any second hand in the museum. Have you got any idea who it is?
No idea.
Hazard a guess?
Mickey Mouse.
Close. Very close, as you'll find out, but not quite. Danny's over there with the girls now, actually.
To find out the biggest celebrity that you'd like to have at your house.
It's got to be Brad.
Brad. I'm with you. And who would you like to have?
I wouldn't mind Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise. Might be a mission impossible. I don't know. Who would you like? Sylvester Stallone. Well, shall we?
What do you think, Vanessa? Because you're interviewing this person.
I can give a little clue.
Uh-huh.
A very, very wonderful Shakespearean actor or actress.
So it could be Mickey Mouse.
A wonderful performance of Juliet hanging over the balcony.
Fine, all right then, let's go and find out who it is now. He's about to turn up any second now. When you see him, chant his name. Here he comes!
Cheers. Richard, not to love that shirt, man.
Thank you.
All right,
there. Right. Come on, Frank. Yeah, give it to you later. I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll send him into the house. We'll get the mom to give him a cup of tea. We'll see you later. There's lots more going on here. Gabrielle performing street parties. The whole works. It's back to the house.
Hey, thank you very much. What? Look at that. Frank Bruno in their house this morning. Whole street turned out to say hello. It's our 1,000th edition. And for one day only, we are playing this. Oh, look at me go. Look at me go. Yes. It's our pit of 1,000 balls, and here to play for us, the one and only Miss Julia Carling!
Hi, Julia!
Wow! And your little one!
This is, well, it's not my little one, it's my, wow, she started already!
Wait,
she
was playing. That's, who is it?
This is Lottie, this is my niece.
Hello, Lottie, how you doing? Hey, do the acrobatics again.
All right, are we ready?
You ready, Lottie?
Ready.
OK, we count three. One, two, three. Look at this. Your turn, Julia. Come on, away you go.
Oh, will you throw me in?
One, two, three.
Oh!
Yes.
Oh!
Okay, in here, right. We've got
Lottie,
1,000
come on.
Balls. And there's 1,000 numbers on them as well. A few have disappeared now, I think.
Oh, it's so exciting.
All right, you've got to dance around in there. When the music stops, you pick a ball, right?
Right.
And on the ball's a number. There's a forfeit or a fake there for you.
Right.
Okay, good luck, Julia Carling. Play the music.
Dance,
away
Lottie.
You go.
Come on, Lottie.
And
ready?
There she goes.
Oh, whoa! Come on, Lottie.
Wow. What a star. Okay, give me a ball with a number on. Julia, give me
right,
a ball with a number
on. We're going to pick a ball. What about this one?
Lottie, that you
one?
Pick one.
This one?
What have you got?
Yes, that's the one.
Okay, that's the one, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, 26, right at the top, an easy one. Yeah, look,
two
hang on, I've
six.
Got 26. Heaven knows what's in these things.
You do?
I don't.
I get a feeling that you do.
Not Julia, I do not know. Do I know?
Yes! Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, could you read out what's on there, please? It's quite a tough one for you this morning, is it?
I need Lily for this one.
Look, shall I read it out, or are you going to do it?
Okay,
Julia Carling, your forfeit is to look on in a sympathetic and caring way while our team of top surgeons play the popular children's game Operation. So, Julia, just for you, can we have Julia's gown, please? OK. Now, look, we're going to be awarding points for this. So the gown goes on. Now, we've got to get the right camera angle, the right position for Julia. Have you ever taken part in an operation before?
I will on you later.
And I can't wait. OK, Julia, step over here with me. Thank you, Helen. All right, great. Let's set up the old camera angle. Have we got a camera through there? Yes, that's right. OK. The operating table comes through. Now, if you'd just like to stand there.
Hello, ma'am.
Julia Carling, in a sympathetic and caring way, you have 10 seconds to look on. Go for it.
Scalpel. Thank you.
Hey, Julia, look over here.
Another medical
object. Oh, very good.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Give her a big round of applause. Julia Carling, you're a star. Thank you very much. Cheers.
Hang on a minute.
What?
Hang on a minute. No! It can't possibly be. It's Alexandra Paul and Jason Simmons from Baywatch. Yeah! Welcome to the show. Thanks so much for joining us. With us all morning. Alexandra was a bit concerned about doing this to you.
Well, she, well, I was. Surprised.
She was very concerned about doing this to you.
We had a nice chat beforehand.
She's a game girl, Julia, isn't she? Coming up in 3 minutes' time, E17 will be playing live in our kitchen. Everybody's with us all morning. You're watching The Big Breakfast. It's our 1,000th episode. And it's not going to get much better than this.
Hi, this is Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yes, for breakfast this morning, I had
small cup of coffee,
cauliflower,
Marmite, and
what did I have for breakfast?
Salt bacon with
grapefruit and bagels.
I had some papaya, and then I had
papaya.
I don't eat breakfast.
That's breakfast and some vitamins, kids. Don't forget to take your vitamins.
If you want to be a player, watch
The Big Breakfast.
Right, tea break over. Yeah, where's Bob?
You know what he's had for breakfast?
In the van. Get some water
running. Weetabix has got enough whole wheat goodness to help keep you going all morning long.
Oi, Bob! Blimey, you had some too?
Weetabix, once we've started you, there's no stopping you.
What do I expect from my conditioner?
To leave my hair looking this soft, this healthy, all the way to the tips. I used to cut off split ends, now I hardly have any. The Pro Vitamin in Pantene's Pro V Conditioner penetrates deep down, while its advanced formula protects and conditions your hair all the way to the tips. So my hair's shiny, soft, and manageable. Pantene Pro V Conditioner, for hair that looks so healthy it shines. Split ends.
I don't worry about them.
New Chappie, with its fish, white meat and cereals, has everything to keep a dog really healthy.
Goodbye, Mum.
Hey. Hello, Dad.
Oh, Chappie, hasn't she fed you yet?
Oh, it's a dog's life.
You and your home are unique, so Direct Line. Tailor make a home insurance policy just for you. We note the exact location of your home, the security arrangements, the age of the house, even the age of the owners. By taking into account things like these, in one short call, we can offer the precise cover you need without paying more than you want. Call Direct Line on 0113 246 8877.
New Dixell Kitten Soft is state-of-the-art toilet tissue technology. Why? Because of its dimples. Thousands of tiny dimples that not only make Kitten Soft softer than ever, but seal the layers together. Dixell Kitten Soft isn't just another toilet tissue. I believe it's the future of toilet tissue. Anything to add, Brian? Brian? Well?
No.
Thank you.
This is the 25th of July. It's our 1,000th show! Yay! Yay! Now look, we're giving away a camera to 1,000 callers, a camera each to 1,000 callers this morning. Joanne, how's it going?
Very busy.
Yeah, good reaction from the callers. Yeah, what about you, Emma? How's it going?
Very, very well.
He told me a minute ago, Nino told me, somebody ordered a pizza.
Got it.
Now, I must say, watch how you dial carefully, because there's a factory just round the corner who've had 300 calls this morning.
Maggie complained as well, because she's getting phone calls.
We're going to rust the camera too.
And the last squidgy bits.
Oh, right. Okay, well, we did warn you at the start of the week to remember the number. Our number, here are a few of the digits from it. 0181 985 query. And our 1,000th caller this morning will win a trip to the States. Okay, enough from me and the outside and the sunshine. Let's go inside with Zoe.
Hi, Jess.
Thanks very much, Keith. E17 are in the house. Joining us on our 1,000th show today. Now, you've been in the press a lot recently. Yeah. And, Brian, you've got nodules on your larynx.
Yeah.
And the doctors have ordered you. You've got to rest. And so you've had to put your tour dates back until December.
Yeah.
How's this affected you and the band?
It's all right. You know what I mean? I've had a bit of time off and stuff. You know what I mean? I don't have to work as much. But...
We love time off.
Hey?
You enjoy it?
Yeah.
Well, you've got quite a hectic schedule, though, haven't you? Yeah. So, but answer the question for us once and for all. Some papers have said you are, some papers have said you're not.
No, we're not.
Are you splitting up?
No, we're not.
You're not?
Yes! Yes!
Yes! Yes! Yes! Yes! Yes! Okay, they're here with a new single, Someone to Love, Take It Away, Boys.
First thing in the morning when you just arose, your eyes still closed. You're getting up, you're feeling down. Maybe it's cause your bed's creased on one side. You can't hide your face from smiling, while your heart wears a frown. Always moving on, no place to call home. Living alone, why should it have to be this way? We all need someone to love. We all need someone to love. Holding and kissing you when you go missing you. Keeping you warm through the cold of the night. We all need someone to love. You run and you hide when you're hurting inside from memories. You can't get away from the pain in your heart. Toss and you turn, you've seen all you remember was a childhood dream. Can't keep it together while your world falls apart. You're just like them, but they don't agree. Living alone, why does it have to be this way? We all need someone to love. And you keeping you warm through the cold of the night. We don't need
Main stories on Thursday, the 25th of July. It's official, smoking causes cot death. Another win makes it triple gold for Ireland's Michelle. Why Wallace and Gromit are right up your street. A new health campaign nails smoking as the major cause of Britain's 500 cot deaths each year. The shock new findings back up campaigners' beliefs. Scientists say 100 deadly chemicals in cigarette smoke kill 7 British babies every week, and the government's backing them with a massive new health campaign. Divers searching the wreckage of the crashed TWA jet in New York have found both black boxes, the flight data and cockpit voice recorders. Recovery teams have brought them ashore and they're now on their way to Washington. They'll solve the mystery of Flight 800. 10,000 defence industry jobs are safe thanks to a decision by the government to spend £3.5 billion on new military hardware. The orders for new aircraft and missiles were only placed with British firms after Deputy Prime Minister Michael Heseltine intervened to stop work going abroad. It's another day of chaos for commuters in London. Virtually no tubes are running on the network as two unions strike over pay and conditions. Hopes of a settlement are at an all-time low. Relatives of a 4-year-old boy abandoned in a park in Bournemouth are pleading with his mother to telephone. Julie Lane called police to check that Stephen was okay before hanging up. He's being looked after by foster parents. Royal insiders say the decision to end the BBC's monopoly on the Queen's Christmas speech was taken to punish the corporation for screening Diana's Panorama interview. The palace denies any link. ITV will produce the Christmas Day message on alternate years. Triple Oscar winners Wallace and Gromit are now making their mark on the map. A new housing development in Bristol is to feature two new streets called Gromit Grove and Wallace Walk. It's the city's tribute to the Pleistocene pair's creator, Nick Park. Ireland's Michelle Smith has stunned Atlanta with yet another swimming gold. Victory in the 200 metres individual medley gave her a third Olympic crown, and she still has one more title to go for. She can't believe it. Irish eyes were smiling in Atlanta following Michelle's performance, but fans are furious at allegations of drug use in the American media. But Britain's Nick Gillingham is quitting swimming without a third Olympic medal. The 29-year-old finished fourth in the 200 metres breaststroke final. He won bronze in Barcelona and silver in Seoul. After day five of the Olympics, Russia are back on top, one gold ahead of the United States, with the French taking over third place. Now the weather warm and sunny with cool light winds in England and Wales, but Scotland and Northern Ireland will start misty with rain due later. And temperatures are up on yesterday, hitting 23 degrees centigrade in the southeast. In yesterday's Big Breakfast News, we told you how the Mardi Gras bomber is targeting Sainsbury's with blackmail threats. We also said that Tesco stores had been targeted. We now know Tesco's aren't involved, and we're happy to put the record straight. 8.03, we're back at 8.20. It's back to the house.
Hey, thank you very much, Peter. Well, I don't normally get the chance to interview such a big star, and it really is a momentous occasion, Peter, in television just for me, because I have a chance to interview a man whose career will span more than 30 years. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Sir Bob Geldof!
Very well, thanks, Keith.
Thank you very much. Bob Geldof, cheers! Great! Well, didn't it? I was a bit nervous at the top of it there.
But you just left him in there.
Hey?
Have you just left him in
there? Yeah, just did a big interview with him.
Oh, really?
Very good. Very, very succinct, Bob. OK. Alexandra Paul and Jason Simmons in the house, cheers!
Thank you, thank you!
Thank you so much
yes,
for coming in
on
such a special
day.
I hear you guys are reading some very intellectual newspapers here.
Yes.
Do you know what? All of a sudden I felt very guilty about Bob.
Really?
Well, yeah, I had to come in and ask him.
Bob, come and join us!
Do you want to come and join us? Maybe he's having a coffee.
Is he having a coffee and things?
What's Bob doing? Bill?
Bill!
You don't want to know.
All right, OK, we'll leave Bob in there then.
Probably stunned by the interview, I think. Probably took him aback there. Hey, you know, we've got the papers of today.
Yeah.
Well, I've got the papers of yesterday here. Actually, 1,000 editions of The Big Breakfast to go. We've got a selection of them there. Let's just look at a quick look at the headlines. A sad one, actually. A young child who was 2 years of age who was hooked on cigarettes. Yeah, because her family smoked, she got this sort of nicotine fix. And every so often she used to sort of nick cigarettes and things.
At two years of age.
And I just heard on your show earlier today is that babies who inhale smoke are more likely to die crib deaths.
Oh, that's right.
So there's kind of a circle.
And Liz Taylor, on the 28th of September 1992, it says here, got £2 million. £2 million for a voiceover on... Where are we?
You've lost your brains I've now.
You're covering up people's things. I was wondering what you were doing. The Simpsons, she did a little voiceover.
Yes.
She got £2 million
for one word.
£2 million.
Yeah. So today, 3 years later, she'd get, 4 years later, she'd get, ten million probably?
Yeah. And Brian Gould decided to quit... from the Shadow Cabinet. Nice little thing about the 10p changed on that day as well. Look, the 10p piece went from that big coin there. You see that one there? Do you remember that one?
Yeah, I used to like those. Yeah. Heavy, they made you feel like you had some money in your pocket.
See, it's quite a heavy coin, that. It's not worth anything now, you can't
use it.
But
when they do, they make it smaller so they can save on silver or whatever.
I don't know why they're...
It's not silver, it's a mixture of sort of steel
and...
Oh,
is it?
Oh, yeah, shit. I know all these things, mate.
See, someone said this morning that this wouldn't be interesting, and look, everyone's really interested in this.
There you go. Let's look at the papers of today.
Well, I'd just like to say, Lisa Ianson, who was on the show with Zigginsag, great friend of Zigginsag, she's pregnant. Congratulations, Lisa.
She's pregnant on Radio 1, you're not allowed to do that.
She is.
My sister couldn't.
Well done to Lisa, congratulations.
A cab trip in the Sun newspaper here. I'll take the high road, or the higher road it says here. A lady got stranded in London. You're covering up the bits as well. She got stranded in London and the rail company paid for a cab all the way up to Scotland and it cost them £884 to get up there. Incredible.
Could have flown to Australia and back, couldn't it?
Yeah, what have you found?
Wouldn't it just fly?
I know, it'd be cheaper, wouldn't it? What have you found?
I found Kimberly.
Kimberly Davis.
Hey, Kimberly.
Now, she can work on Baywatch, and she's even wearing a red dress.
She could hire her like that.
Yeah. She could be on Baywatch.
Hey, there's also the Queen there. Yes. She's not doing her telly speech on BBC anymore. Well, she's going to the ITV for 2 years, and then she's going back. Well, a heck of a contract she's got, isn't she? Wouldn't mind finding out who her agent is.
Is she getting as much as Elizabeth
Taylor?
She's
going to the other
side. More than likely.
She's going to the other side for the
Christmas. Really? Ooh, Auntie BBC. The BBC will be
hey, don't touch that. We're waiting for our 1,000th callers to come through. That siren will go woo, 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 woo. And we'll have to get out of it. Could go woo, 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 woo.
How many lines do you have accepting those calls?
We've got about 15, 20 people on the phones this morning.
Wow.
And more. 1,000 callers we're after. 1,000 cameras given away. Have you found anything in the paper?
No, I was too busy looking at you. Here, let's see.
Who's that? Michael and...
Michael Hutchins. Paula and Michael Hutchins. There's a picture of them. Oh, does your nail varnish vanish?
Oh, yeah, mine does. Do you have this problem too?
Yeah, because my nails are short.
Does it have a cure? Oh, just lots of different... Oh, it's just an
Yeah, that's him. Oh, okay.
Well, there we go. Okay, that's the papers today.
And yesterday. More from these two a little bit later on as well, but they're out and about this morning, aren't they?
They're in Kettleridge, the Kettleridge family in Essex.
Oh, it's time to shout.
Where are you?
Richard!
Richard!
Thank you very much. Yeah, we're still in Whittam in Essex, and we're at the family of the Kettleridge Jeffreys household. Yeah! Yes! Very excited. And that is it. Mr. Bruno! Bruno! How's it going? Oh, did he hurt you, Fred?
Yeah, he did hurt me as well. I'm going to tell your mum, are you?
I'll tell you what, Ryan's been up for a fight all morning, haven't you, Ryan? He fancies his chances as Frank, I tell you. It could be a bit of a scrap on later on.
Yeah, tell him. Yeah, please.
You want him to sit down there, yeah? You tell him, Louise, all right?
Yeah, he's been naughty.
Can't believe it, he's taking Frank on. All right, should we go next door? We're going to do a bit of a Daniel Dorsett steady there, Grant. I tell you, there's hardly any room to move around here.
Love that
shirt. Thanks very much, Frank.
Love that shirt. See you later, family of the week. Come on, follow me.
Come
and see here.
Next door.
Yeah, I'm coming, Richard.
Next door. I tell you, very hard to keep track here. So many people around. You've seen the crowd? Look at the crowd. Incredible. Hello, everybody. Right, we're at the next door neighbour's house, to the Kettleridge Jeffreys. Danny's going to talk to them. In you go, in you go.
Go on in there, fella.
How are you doing?
Fine.
Enjoying the party spirit?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, now we need some party frocks for outside.
Yeah,
where's the bedroom? So upstairs. Frank in the house.
She's got her vest off already, hasn't she? I like that. All right, you say you all live here, do you?
No.
Yes. Just wandering in. Now, we've got a party happening outside. What's your best party trick that you could do? You're on camera.
Go. Are you on the spot?
I did not party.
We can't have that today.
No, I can't do none. Oh, Chris Eubanks, yeah.
Good stuff. All right, then, later on, we've got Gabrielle performing in your front garden. Yeah. Can you believe it? Yes! In your front garden!
Join the party!
Yeah! Freak down! Yeah.
Break down with Frank Bruno at Witcham in Essex at 1000 show. It's all going off here. It's back to the house.
Cook here.
Hello! Hello! Yes, here we are!
And, have you guys been discussing kissing strategy?
Don't give anything away now, because anybody who watches Baywatch will know that there's a lot more to Baywatch than bouncing bait. Of course, there's the patrol, the recovery, and most importantly, the kiss of life. And today we have three very fine fellows, morning, Paul. Fine fellows standing by, all ready to test out their kiss of life technique on Alexandra here. You don't mind that, Alexandra, do you?
No, I think I'll survive.
You'll survive. Okay, we're going to go through here into the hallway. Come with me. Into the hallway. This is where it gets all very, very exciting. And you're going to come in here because there's a slight catch to this little number. As you can always tell, there will be on the breakfast here. Because we want to see if it really is in his kiss. Okay, we're going to put a blindfold on you.
Oh, you're getting kinky.
And then we're getting kinky. We're going to put a blindfold on you. There we go.
Okay.
And I'm just going to check if you really can see nothing. Can you see anything?
No, I can't see.
She can't see anything. Are you sure?
I can feel, though.
No, she can't see anything there. She can feel. Because what we're going to do is we're going to ask you to kiss each one of those fellows. There was Jason there, and Keith, and Sir Bob. Okay. And we're going to ask you who you're kissing. If you can tell who you're kissing. All right? Okay? You know the rules? It's quite simple. Okay, so can kisser number one please step forward? Oh, Keith's muddling them up first. Keith's muddling them up outside.
Can I touch them?
Has he muddled them up?
Can I touch them?
Are they ready, muddle up?
Just 2 seconds, is that all right?
Okay, just 2 seconds. We'll just wait a few more seconds.
Can I touch them?
You can you what?
Touch them.
You can touch them.
I can.
You can touch them.
Okay, Zoe.
Can she touch them? Can she touch them? She can touch them, but it's really in the kiss. They're ready now. Okay, so can kisser number one step forward, please? Okay. Nobody say anything.
Where are you?
Okay, step forward and kiss Alexandra.
Where are you? Oh, man.
Mike, stop it, you. Stay. It's supposed to be a little kiss.
Shush.
Okay.
That was fantastic.
Alexandra, who did you think that was? Just guess. I'm not going to tell you whether you're right or wrong.
Blindfold down.
Who do you think? Keith?
It was Keith.
You think it was Keith? Yeah. Okay, well, I'm not going to say anything yet. Can kisser number two step forward, please? Cheeky. Okay, we have kisser number two. Shh. Don't give the game away. Okay, here we go. Look, kisser number two. Excuse me, this is family television. Yeah, all right, okay, stop. Oh, I wonder if you can guess who that was then, Alexandra.
I have no idea, some mysterious stranger.
Okay, you two control yourself. Okay, well, let's bring in kisser number three. Is very, very tense and exciting. Here comes kisser number three.
Oh, how wonderful! No, it's me!
There you have your mystery kisser number
three.
Excuse me! Okay.
How big is it?
My mother is going to be so shocked. Okay. Alexandra. Alexandra, will you take your blindfold off, please?
That was very good.
Do you recognise this man? She doesn't recognise. You don't recognise this man, do you?
No.
You don't recognise. Okay, Alexandra, we'd like you to take yourself back.
No! Stop!
20 years!
Stop it!
20 years to when you were at primary school. And
I can't believe it. Stop it. Are you
this child? It's Bob. He has flown all the way from Connecticut. And these two, he's her first kiss. When she was 11 years old.
I'm so...
But didn't he run off with your twin sister?
Yes, he did. You had...
Oh, well.
Yeah, not only did he have me and my twin sister, but he were my first love. I can't believe it.
She is genuinely gobsmacked.
I'm stunned.
How is it? Has she changed at all?
Just as lovely as ever.
That's an amazing moment.
And was that kiss better than the first? Can we do a slow dance? Because we used to dance in eighth grade.
Oh, come on. Yeah. Yeah.
Like that? Like we did back then? Yeah. Real corny?
We better not. No, Stairway to Heaven, you know, 12 minutes.
Yeah.
Oh, really? Gabrielle will be joining them a little bit later on. Prav, I'll dance with you. Look, Prav and I'll dance.
But right now, we're talking about favourite moments. We've been asking you to... Prav, you're a good dancer, mate. Asking you about favourite moments. And Paul Hinton from Portsmouth, he's got his favourite moment coming up right now. Will you get off my foot?
Now, let's have a go at the Ferrari in the skies.
Gonna go for maneuverability. Oh, blimey. Here we go.
No, not yet. He's on the verge, though.
Isn't he? Okay.
Yes, he has.
On this quick.
Magic carpet! Hey! Got you!
Nesquik cereal. Delicious Nesquik chocolate taste.
Nesquik cereal. Nesquik taste from the first bite to the last drop.
And now from Disney's The Hunchback of Notre Dame, free figurines in special packs of Nesquik cereal.
There's delicious, juicy flavour just bursting to be set loose from every Maynard's original wine gum. All you've got to do is chew!
Mom, there's juice loose about this house. Set the juice loose!
Get ready for a magical adventure that will take you over the rainbow.
Way to go, Mike!
And beyond. Rainbow.
Helene Curtis salon experts have created the Salon Selectives hair care range, so you can choose the exact combination to help you make your hair its most beautiful.
Is it here?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
The heat's on, you'll keep your cool. Because Natrel Plus has a new ingredient that releases fresh protection again and again and again.
Reach out of space.
It's back, Untitled 2. 40 amazing tracks, a superb double album.
Today is going to be the day that they're going to throw it back to you.
The queen. Classic tracks and the best in new music with Garbage, Ash, Oasis and Supergrass. Untitled 2 is what your stereo was made for.
Congratulations on your 1,000 shows and Big Breakfast. You all must be very tired. Keep going.
You know, half a dozen times, so that they could get the melody kind of sunk in.
Okay, we're actually going to play it for the very first time. This is the demo tape.
Yeah.
moment on The Big Breakfast. Thanks to Ian Purcell from Newcastle for his favourite moment from July the 13th, 1995. So Bob Geldof in the house, yay! Yeah!
It's a what?
It's a Bob Geldof.
Hey, great audition I'm doing, isn't it? Hey, look, can you do any better? You do it, go on. Coming up next.
What? Oh.
Go on.
Where?
There.
Coming up next, Frank Bruno is quizzed by Mrs. Ketterich from Witham Essex about his controversial return to boxing.
That's good. Yeah, go on. What else?
We're going to put some clothes on Baywatch's Alexander Paul.
Oh, what a shame.
About time. About time. About time, too. And in 10 minutes' time, we'll be looking back on 1,000 Big Breakfasts in Snap, Crackle and Pop.
It's all here on The Big Breakfast. Coming up now with the time at... Well done, Bob, yes. Bunch of creeps. 8:21 is the time. Pete Smith, Big Breakfast News and Weather.
Top stories. Scientists say cigarette smoke is the main cause of Britain's 500 cot deaths each year. A two-year study shows that two-thirds of the tiny victims could be saved if they were given a smoke-free environment. Divers investigating the mystery of TWA Flight 800 have brought ashore the crucial black boxes. The flight data and cockpit voice recorders are now on their way to Washington. They'll help determine whether terrorism or mechanical failure caused the disaster. Ireland's Michelle Smith has stunned Atlanta with yet another swimming gold. Victory in the 200 metres individual medley gave her a third Olympic crowd, and she still has her strongest event to come. She can't believe it.
Oh, it seems like a dream at this point in time. I think I'm living in a dream at the moment. I think I'll only believe it after the swimming is over.
Irish eyes were smiling in Atlanta following Michelle's performance, but fans are furious at allegations of drug use in the American media.
It has been a disgrace. Absolute disgrace.
Now the weather, a warm sunny day in England and Wales with plenty of fresh breezes, but expect more rain over Scotland and Northern Ireland. Temperatures are climbing slightly to an average of 21 degrees centigrade. 8:22, we're back at 8:40, here's Zoe.
Thanks very much, Pete. Here we are floating on the pool because today's guests, we thought they're used to spending so much time in the water. And we did toy with the idea of going in the lock, but then we thought, no, that's a bit too cruel. So here we are having a lovely cosy chat, apart from the fact that Alexandra is right over there. Alexandra, pull us over, there we go. Alexandra Paul and Jason Simmons. Give them a cheer then, guys. Sorry,
you're going to stop the sound. You can't go, but I can. OK, round the side of the house. Watch your step there, Joey, as we go. Morning! Good morning, Ben! OK, who's got the next call? We've stopped in the line. We've got one call down here. Have you got it, Nick?
Yes, I do, Keith.
Brilliant. OK, let's go for that phone.
All right.
OK. Hello?
Hello?
Hello, Keith Chegwin, Big Breakfast. Who's phoning?
Graham Garvin.
Graham Durbin,
yeah.
You are our 1,000th caller.
I can't believe it.
And do you know what happens to the 1,000th caller?
I think we remember you went a trip to America.
You've done it. Well done. What part of the world are you from?
Dundee, up in Scotland.
Oh, great. And are you... Stop it. Are you going to be celebrating in Dundee tonight?
Definitely.
Great, you're going to Iowa, where we actually shot the film Twister. You haven't seen that film yet, have you?
No, I haven't, no.
Oh, well, you go around the location, you'll do loads of things. When did you last go away on holiday?
It was about 2 years ago.
Oh, what? And who are you going to be taking with you?
I'm not sure yet.
Great. Is there anybody in your house at the moment?
No, I'm actually phoning from work.
Oh, you're phoning from work?
Take your boss.
What do you actually do for a living?
I build ATMs, you know, automatic teller machines.
Oh, right.
World bank machines.
Oh, clever stuff. Oh, right. Oh, so you got a few quid already then. All right, congratulations and well done. Enjoy your trip.
Thank you very much.
Do me a favour, say thank you to all our guest stars here this morning.
They've been answering the phone calls like mad.
I told
you, Graham.
You get a camera as well, but also for those 999 callers, you all get cameras, those little clever things, Polaroid things, and with the talks to you and what have you. Okay. Thanks very much, Nick. Thanks, team. Cheers, Joanne. See you in a moment. Let's go right round there. You all right, Jerry? Hey, do it on your own. Go find Zoe.
Thank you very much, Keith. I'd like to do that little introduction again. Let's welcome them once again to the show, Jason Simmons and Alexandra Paul from Baywatch. Welcome to the show, guys. Here we are on our very, very comfortable furniture. Look, give us a pull because we're getting separated here. So what brings you to our shores this week?
Well, we're going to the Ascot charity races tomorrow.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
We're losing you.
Come back.
and I'll look, I'll paddle.
So speaking of water, they're on Friday, and they're raising money for three water-based charities. Oh, so sort of there's a good tie-in with Jason and
So do you two travel a lot together?
Yes.
Yes, whenever we can.
Yeah, and are the rumours true? Because lots of the papers have said that you two are slightly more than just acting pals.
No, what are you asking?
Well, I'm asking, is she your girlfriend?
Are you asking it that?
Yes, that's what I am asking.
No comment.
No comment.
No comment. Oh, really? You can't tell us any more than
that?
Oh, well, I know
what
that means then, basically.
Nice try.
It was a nice try. Yeah. Okay. Okay, do you think it was perhaps that nude photograph that you did together that sparked off these rumours?
It was her idea.
Was it your idea?
You were the first one to take your clothes off.
It was your idea.
Was it?
Yeah,
remember. Love is tip going on here. Love
is fun, though.
And now Baywatch. Less about you two together, okay? Now Baywatch the show. In fact, no more about you two together. No, we'll talk about that later. Baywatch the show is said to be the most popular show in the whole world. Do you think it's true?
Yes, actually, I know it's true. Because it's in more countries than any other show in the world. So.
Excuse me, I think we're squashing a man.
Shh, don't mention the man.
Oh, sorry. There's no man.
Is it as popular in America as it is over here? Because, I mean, it's, you know, huge ratings over here, Baywatch.
I think people in America are a little sort of cynical about Baywatch. They don't have
sense of humor.
Sense of
the
humor
show
about
is
it.
Funny. It's
it
a fun show.
It's like light entertainment.
You just have to sit back
in America, people are irritated that we're having such a good time, I think.
Really? They get a bit jealous and they can't bear to watch it.
I don't know. Anyway, it's really huge in Europe and Asia and Iran.
Because I think it's because of the California lifestyle more than anything and what fuels the bathing suits.
And what feels, yes, less about that.
Some bathing suits.
Yeah,
some
not all suits. Of them. You've got an all-star.
You filled your bathing
proud.
Suit just
Alexandra,
right.
You have a fantastic figure. I mean, talking of filling bathing suits, is there any jealousy and rivalry between the cast? Because some people get more press than others, perhaps?
No. No, not at all.
Not at all. I mean, if you're talking about Pamela, she works really hard for the press that she get. I mean, very, very hard. Harder than I would be able to, you know, or would
She's
want
great.
To. And so she deserves it.
Have you met her baby? Have you seen the baby?
Yeah, I saw her baby. Yes, was it yesterday or the day before?
Two days ago.
Yeah, rather cute.
Really
she's
cute.
She's really proud showing Brandon around everywhere.
Is she breastfeeding?
I didn't see that part.
Yes, I heard she
is
was.
She?
Yes.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. Oh, fantastic. Oh, yeah. Sorry. I just had to ask that question. Now, Baywatch is coming up for its seventh series in the autumn.
Yes.
But there is a rumour that you're both going to be leaving. Halfway
yes.
through,
yes,
what? Yeah. Is it a coincidence that you're both leaving at the same time?
Well, I wouldn't have wanted to be on the show without him.
Oh, that's so sweet.
But we actually made our decisions independently.
Separately, yeah.
Yes, I've been on the show for 4.5 years, so it's been great. It's the best show to work. I mean, aren't you having a fun time on this right here?
This
you can
great?
Imagine we do it
this
every
is
day.
It's just like the sea in California.
Yes.
It's all very
the sun.
So what are you going on to do then? Where are we going to be able to see you next?
Well, Jason's got 3 movies.
3?
Yeah, and I'm starting to produce my own film, starting in a couple of months.
My goodness, I mean, what are your movies? What can we look out for them? What are their names?
One is Nowhere, Greg Rock with Christina Applegate, Shannon Doherty, Tracy Lords, all those wonderful people. I did a movie with Stacey Keach called Seawolf, which is coming out, and did a movie with Chrissy Amphlett from The Divinals.
So we'll look out for all of those, and yourself, Alexandra?
She has 2 movies, a movie of the week, and a pilot.
Thank you. You answer each other's questions. Thank you. You're going to stick around for the rest of the show?
Oh, yeah.
Why not?
The two lovers. I tell you what we should do. We should swap so you can sit on this sofa.
That'll be dangerous.
So.
I think
like
she'd get
one.
In the water.
I like this one.
I enjoyed our chat. Thank you very, very much. And I've just got to turn the page here. Can you do this for me? Actually, what's happening now?
What's happening
Excuse
now?
Me. Ah, what is happening now?
It's getting wet.
Where's the man?
Where's the man?
The man. We need the man.
Hey.
Where's the man?
We drowned
there he
him.
Is. Hello. What's happening now, sir?
Where are you?
The camera.
Where are you, Richard,
Danny
and Vanessa?
Thank you very much, sir.
It is absolutely crazy here. 1,000 shows. And look who's joined us. It's Gabrielle. Hello, Gabrielle.
Hi.
Thanks for coming down. Enjoying it?
I am.
Have you ever seen anything like it?
No, it's fabulous.
And you're going to be performing a song for us later on, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
What is it?
Have you ever wondered it's on the new album?
Why did you choose that?
Because it's such an up song.
Looking forward to it. Looking forward to Gabrielle and Frank Bruno.
Yes, Gabrielle.
Yeah.
How
the Black and
feel?
Decker in the house, very, very good. Getting the suntan and all these people.
He's
very,
a
very
funny
good, Danny.
Man today. Yeah,
cheers.
Crazy in
Thank
the
you.
Crowd.
Oh, yeah, cheers.
And Gabrielle is our carnival queen.
Hi.
You've just been on the carnival Gabrielle. Queen. You get to wear the carnival queen set.
Oh.
Thank you. And I think we should start the procession.
I think so.
Like
let's start the procession.
Yes.
Let's just wait till all the punters
run with it.
Hey, look at that. What a morning on down your doorstep today, and what a day. Okay, coming up later on during the course of the morning, Bob will tell you all.
Frank Bruno was quizzed by Mrs. Ketteridge from Witham in Essex about his controversial return to boxing. Don't do it, Frank. We're going to put some clothes on Baywatch's Alexander Paul. And you've picked the clothes, haven't you?
Yeah, I certainly have. Yes.
And Gabrielle will be singing.
Tight, you know, things.
We'll be singing out the show.
Excellent. Good news. Okay, we're asking you your favourite moments. We asked you to write in, and this is Mandy Freeman's favourite moment. She's from Liverpool, and it goes back to July 6, 1995. Here it comes.
It's now just gone 7:10. We don't have a clock on the screen. We know we had a power cut. We had two power cuts here at the Big Breakfast House. So you've got our outtakes tape and just remembering of all those times that we looked at. And also we went to a break. But please stay with us because this is very exciting television. You never know when we might go away again. Yay! But we're
what's the nuttiest thing you've ever done?
They call us the terrible twins. In maths groups, we swap maths books. They kept on getting this wrong. They swap badges. Me, Sam, and Mark.
Nope! You nuttiest sunbat! It's the nuttiest thing you've ever done.
Sometimes they notice, sometimes they don't.
New Dixell Kitten Soft is state-of-the-art toilet tissue technology. Why? Because of its dimples. Thousands of tiny dimples that not only make kittens soft, softer than ever, but seal the layers together. Dixell Kitten Soft isn't just another toilet tissue. I believe it's the future of toilet tissue. Anything to add, Brian? Brian? Well?
No.
Yes, Martin, it's a tracksuit.
I can see that, Dad, but what's it doing on you?
It's part of my new healthier lifestyle. The first step, Kellogg's Bran Flakes. They're high in fibre, low in fat.
They taste great. So as well as eating Kellogg's Bran Flakes, you'll be jogging to the newsagents every day?
Yep.
Kellogg's Bran Flakes, a step in the right direction.
One step at a time, Martin.
Cut out the 5 coupons on every promotional pack of Kellogg's Bran Flakes and you'll get Monday to Friday of the Daily Mail free. But hurry.
Many congratulations to the Big Breakfast on their 1,000th show without anyone walking into the camera. Well done.
Oh, God, blimey.
We had a hoot. She was the girl that had the flute. She was the girl that played the flute. She was a girl, she owned a flute. Which was very, very difficult to play. Very, very difficult to play. That's why I loved her. I love her to this day. Oh, yes!
Welcome back to the 1,000th episode of The Big Woo! Breakfast. Chris Evans there with Zig and Zag, and that clip was chosen by Leslie Hendry from Edinburgh. That was his favourite moment.
Mm. Hey, you know that guy I phoned up for the competition
yeah.
who won the trip to America?
Yeah.
Well, I did something really stupid. I put the phone down.
Again!
So, Graham, you can go on holiday, but you've got to call again. Because we need your address. Okay, the number we can tell you now is 0181 985 1111. And Graham, you're at work, so you might be able to use the fax, which is 0181 985 1222. Okay, time for Snap, Cackle and Pop.
Snap, Cackle, Pop.
To mark 1,000 sparkling shows, today's Fact Pack Snap brings you everything you ever wanted to know about The Big Breakfast. And more.
Good morning!
Good morning!
Good morning!
Good morning!
And we ask the people who matter what the Big Breakfast means to them.
I got into the bedclothes and I had a special pair of pyjamas.
Chris Evans shoving revolting crazy foam cream into my mouth and just about every other orifice he could get it into.
It's
fulfilled every dream I'd ever had and helped me sort of to move on to fulfill more.
On September the 28th, 1992, a new dish was served up to an unsuspecting nation.
I'm Chris.
And I'm Gabby.
OK, I wish I was Richard.
I wish I was you, dear.
But we're not. We will be in 12 months' time, maybe, if we're lucky.
The first time I saw The Big Breakfast, very memorable, actually, it was its very first morning on, and I was having a breakfast myself with a friend of mine who is a record producer, my age, but very much in tune with a younger audience. And I remember him just leaning back and saying, wow, that is sensational. That is just going to make it and wipe everything else off the screen.
Nobody else is doing this, ladies and gentlemen. Nobody else is putting a bagpiper in your back seat.
In the first 1,000 shows, The Big Breakfast has made big headlines and brought you big stars.
Who else? Tom Hanks. Dudley Moore.
I sound like I'm name-dropping, but it was very exciting.
But for every star, there's a story. Today, Snap brings you 10 fabulous facts revealed here for the very first time. Fact number one, the boudoir has been redecorated 5 times. Spot the difference. Fact number two, 47 top celebrities have shown us their pants, including Russell Grant, Danny Minogue, Let Loose and Saint Greavesy. Fact number three, the man on the di-dum button in the newsroom has pushed it an amazing 57,000 times. Fact number four, senior cameraman John Bond Showbiz McKenzie has worked on every single one of the 1,000 shows. Fact number five, all these people have fronted The Big Breakfast. 14 regular and 22 guest presenters altogether. Fact number six, an American version of The Big Breakfast called The Big Day is now being developed.
It is Friday, September 16th, and I'm Mark Steinis.
And I'm Helen Keeney.
Fact number seven, several of the unlikely devices featured on Invention Corner have gone into mass production, like Mr. Malski's golf club cleaner and Bob Hennessy's amazing auto-lowering loo seat. Fact number eight, the most complaints we ever received were for Gabby's reenactment of a certain scene from When Harry Met Sally. Fact number nine, in the first week of the show, two taxi drivers fell into the lock because they couldn't see it in the dark. Fact number 10, school children were once banned from singing Get Your Knobbly Nuts Out, but that didn't stop us.
Get your knobbly nuts out, get your knobbly,
knobbly,
knobbly, get your knobbly nuts out.
Yes, it's fair to say we've made a big impression.
Obviously, loads of people are nicked stuff in The Big Breakfast. I mean, you see far more handheld cameras now. You see far more knocking people up in the morning, all that sort of nonsense. I mean, you only have to study. I won't name these BBC-run shows, but it's obvious that the techniques have been thought, we'll have some of that, and they've just nicked them.
I couldn't point to other shows in particular and say this is what, certainly not on the BBC, and say this is like The Big Breakfast particularly.
And The Big B is still the most talked about show on telly.
My 10-year-old daughter, Freya, is the person who likes to press the knob for Channel 4 in the morning, and that's where I see most of it.
Yes, Big Breakfast is on in this house.
If I'm up, yeah, of course I watch it. It was my baby, you know, and it's fab to watch Zoe doing so well because I love her to pieces.
So what can we all look forward to in the next 1,000 shows?
I'd like them to do it upside down, and I'd also like them to do it underwater. I think that would be good.
I wouldn't turn into a kind of complacent institution if I were the Big Breakfast line. I'd try to find a way of redefining itself, but remaining as bold as it can be.
You just don't know what's going to happen, and I know a lot of television shows in Australia and America don't take that chance.
Another 1,000 and 1,000 and 1,000 and 1,000. But Zoe, watch out, because the wrinkles do start affecting you.
Yeah, as Jon Snow said, they'd like to see us do us upside down. I think that'd be a bit difficult, don't you, Zoe?
I know. I think it's asking a little bit much in the budget. It wouldn't quite reach to that, I don't
think. Yeah, but I have to say, you know, these technical boys here, I mean, we were the first. People copy us on The Big Breakfast. Bob, what do you remember most about the 1,000 shows? Is there any one particular moment that sticks in your mind?
I remember the first one. That's what I remember most of all. Just the idea that you could do anything on TV, and that, you know, this was sort of punk television, and that's what, you know, I'm an old punk, and I thought, well, we'll do it.
And get away with it.
And we did get away with it, you know.
They said that 48 celebrities showed their pants. Pete Smith!
No.
We've never seen your pants!
You're not going to see my pants either.
more thousand before you see them.
Oh, yeah. He used to get them off all the time on stage when he was in a group. Yeah, I used to see him.
Bob.
What? Really? I mean, he couldn't play, so he just used to get his pants down.
That's how he sold tickets.
I think we should get Paddy Ash down to show us.
Hey, very quick. Paddy's right out of time. What's the most memorable moment
for
you?
The first show, I was so nervous. I could barely speak and I could barely see the autocue. The only reason this cup is here is because I was drinking coffee and I'd left it on the set. And it just stayed.
And it's still there.
Cheers, Peter. Stains, isn't it? Okay. Still loads more to come on the show this morning and all morning. We have been showing your favourite clips because you phoned in with them. And this is Peter Boyle and the lads from Belfast's favourite clip from the 11th of June, 1996.
Okay, here we go. Let's kick it out. Opposite elbow.
What's the nuttiest thing you've ever done?
We have to play netball. It's so sad. You can't move your feet.
Yeah, you
You're
can't.
You're sort of like pivoting around and going, oh,
two, pass. Right.
Nope! New nuttiest sunbat!
Yes!
It's the nuttiest thing you've ever done.
Hockey or rugby or something. And if it were boring,
New Kitten Soft is softer than ever before. Buy it.
There's £1 off Bird's Eye Fish Fingers. That's 36 for just £1.99. What a catch. Iceland, we're full of surprises.
Psst, between us guys, you eat Skittles, you expect a hit, right? Lenny and Larry juiced the first two with real juice. One tried to hide. Guess he didn't figure on Ollie and Sally. The undercurrents had the last word.
You never were one of us, Benny.
No softer scent of Skittles. Real fruit for a real hit.
Nothing else in nature...
It's starting to turn!
...can match its raw power.
Get out of there! Come on!
Its uncontrollable fury.
It's coming!
The producers of Jurassic Park... and the director of Speed bring you face to face with Twister.
Ocean Colour Scene with Moseley Shoals. Their fantastic album featuring the riverboat song You've Got It Bad and The Day We Caught the Train. All the hits on one great album. Ocean Colour Scene, Moseley Shoals.
What is Tizer?
Tis. Tisn't. Tis. Tisn't. Tis. Tisn't.
Here's one I prepared earlier.
Get Tis under the cap or wrinkle and you're a winner. Because there's £150,000 worth of fantastic high-tech prizes to be won. Tizer. Tis. Fantastic.
Happy 1,000th birthday, Big Breakfast Show. Vanessa, I love you. You're just fabulous.
Beat the banger. Beat the banger. Beat the banger. Beat the banger.
Welcome back to the 1,000th Big Breakfast. That was a very popular clip. And that came in from Jimmy Warne from Newcastle. That was his favourite from the 17th of October, 1994. Who's that in the middle?
Fergie's
dad. Ron.
Yeah, Major Ron. With the big eyebrows. It's our 1,000th edition. They've got 1,000 people, or more probably, in Essex, as we shout, where are you, Vanessa?
Here we are on the bed with our mystery guest, Frank.
Frank Bruno. Pauline says it's the first time she's been allowed to have another man on a bed and she's thoroughly enjoying it. She's got loads of questions she's always wanted to ask Frank. What do you want to ask him?
How did you meet your wife?
I don't meet my wife. I met my wife roller skating in Battersea Park and she pinched my big black ass. And from then, it was history. You know what I mean? It was history and that was the truth. They weren't made up. Yeah.
She was very brave, wasn't she?
Yeah, very brave, yeah.
And you're going to be very brave if you really do what you say you're going to do and you don't retire.
Yeah, not retiring as yet, Vanessa.
Because I understand that Laura's not keen, your wife.
Not keen at all, I don't think. You know, I don't think anyone's wife would be very keen, Vanessa. But at the end of the day, that's my... I don't mess around with her kitchen and she doesn't mess around with my boxing.
Sexist!
No, don't get physical. The bed's not strong enough to get physical.
I didn't mess around with her kitchen. I thought yours was a marriage of equals.
It's a marriage of equals. What I mean by that is just a joke. Don't get too it's just like a phrase.
But what Laura said, no, really, Frank, I really love you. We've got three gorgeous kids. I really don't want you fighting again.
I've got to take that into consideration, but she hasn't said that as yet. You know what I mean?
I've heard there are rumblings in that direction from Laura.
Rumbling, yeah. You must be a clairvoyant.
Well, no, I've had a little bird telling me.
I'm extra large.
Henry Cooper's come off the fence about the whole thing, hasn't he? Did you read what he said about you?
I don't particularly read what the papers say.
He said you should just sit at home, count your money, and that's all. And he's also worried you're going to get punched up and you're going to have trouble with your eyes and your retina. And he said you can't replace a retina like a battery. Yeah. Frank, stay at home, do panto and be happy.
Pantomime? What, X-ray pantomime or...
Is Henry right?
I don't think so. You know, everybody's entitled to their opinion, Vanessa. That's what people... You've got your wonderful show, you're on here, you're asking me questions. Everyone's got their opinion, but no one has to live with me. I've got to do what makes me happy, and boxing makes me happy. Meeting people and doing various different things up and down the country makes me happy, but I've got to live with myself, so I've got to, you know, I mean, contemplate with my family and see what Frank wants.
Who do you think you might be fighting next?
I might be fighting you or this housewife here, her husband.
If you survive a bout with us, who are you going to
fight? No one's planned as yet, you know. I've got to sit down with Don King and Frank Warren and, you know what I mean, talk over what they've got on offer for me. If it's good, I will take it. If it's not, I'll just, you know what I mean, try and take Nick your job on here, Big Breakfast, or do Ducking and Diving, Vanessa.
What do you think of the thousandth show, The Big Breakfast? Because you did present the show for a while.
Yeah, I did present the show, and I was on the bed with different various stars, and it was very, very good fun, good experience. They're good people to work with, Bob Massey and the crew, you know, very good.
You like it here?
No, I love it.
Pauline, anything else you need to ask Frank?
No.
What do you think?
She's got 9 kids, man. She looks very well, and her husband as well. Unbelievable, you know what I mean? Very unbelievable. Strong ginseng girl, wicked.
What do your kids think about the fact that you've said that you're definitely carrying on?
Mixed feelings, Vanessa, because at the end of the day, the kids are kids. One minute they say this, one minute they say that. Nicola was 14 yesterday, and no doubt they don't want their dad to go and do this. I go away from home and all them sort of different things, Vanessa. But, you know, they're kids. You know?
I like you to stay around and come on the bed with me every morning. No problem. We love you, Bruno.
For your husband,
we
like
love
that.
You. Yeah. Your greatest fan. All right, now we've got to go to a clip. This is the very, very favourite clip of Warren Taylor from Leeds. Here you go. Hey.
Don't be a baby. How am I supposed to feel? With all the things you don't reveal, and you can thank your lucky stars that we're not a prank smart as we like to think we are.
Oh, so I hate to break it.
Sent off many Power Rangers and selected big brands at the Woolworths toy sale. Get there quick.
Psst, between us guys, you eat Skittles, you expect a hit, right? Lenny and Larry juiced the first two with real juice. One tried to hide. Guess he didn't figure on Ollie and Sally. The undercurrents had the last word.
You never were one of us, Benny.
No softer scent of Skittles. Real fruit for a real hit.
Your lips can't lose, guaranteed, with CoverGirl's new self-renewing lipstick. Just press your lips, special microbeads release fresh colour, no need to reapply. Satisfaction guaranteed, or call us free for your money back. New continuous colour, the self-renewing lipstick, from the new look of CoverGirl.
We already know that Max Spielman
have been giving us beautiful quality photos
for over 40 years
at very competitive prices.
But did you know when you buy two films,
you get two free?
That's four films from under £5. And they've got branches throughout the north. Make sure you're the one in front. With Max Spielman, there's a branch near you.
New Kitten Soft is softer than ever before. Buy it.
I built a pussycat on a deadly mountain.
Look, Mum, a bird!
Get a Lego freestyle set with every special pack of Dairy Lee.
What have you built, sweetheart?
It's a single span cantilever suspension bridge.
And he had a feast of lark's tongues and swan's brains.
Lark's watsits and swan's brains, you call that a feast? Look, a feast is a Walls ice cream with knobbly bits on the outside and squishy ice cream round a delicious chunky centre. And no lark's tongues.
If it's not a Walls feast, just say...
No thanks, your imperial bulbosity.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Ross. Congratulations to The Big Breakfast on reaching 1,000 shows. Let's face it, none of us thought it could be possible.
You ready? Yeah. Here we go. Righto. He's out! Out! Four! Six! The leg five!
What's your? Big boy! Oh, yes! Dickie Bird! Welcome back to the 1,000th Big Breakfast. That clip was the favourite of Sue Palmer from Derby, and that was from the 25th of January 1996. Dickie Bird, he was a complete star. Now, it's every girl's nightmare, okay? You've got the old gilt-edged invitation to something very posh, but you've got absolutely nothing to wear. Well, there's a problem in itself, but imagine if you're vegan, okay? You're vegan and you cannot choose anything that contains leather, wool, silk, or any other animal products. Well, that is the problem that Alexandra has. Alexandra, where are you off to?
We're going to the Royal Ascot Charity.
And you're having
Ascot, sorry, I say it the American way. The Royal Ascot Charity Games.
Ascot races, charity. Yeah. There we go. Now, you're having problems finding an outfit. We've scoured the country. We've got together some of the top designers in the country to see if they could design you an outfit. We've got some of them for you to look at. So let's welcome the ladies out of our wonderful marketing. Modeling a lovely rubbery gold snakeskin dress. That is from Stephen. And will cost you a mere £250. Alexandra, what do you think of that dress?
Well, you can see her underwear.
You can see her pants. We're all the see-through. Also,
I think that it would be kind of sweaty.
It is actually quite sweaty, but you know.
Look at you. Can you hear that? Okay, well, if you'd like to stand by there, let's have a look at another outfit. Next up, we have Emma Noble. This is a cream nylon dress with a perfect halter neck collar. This is from Vicky Martin. It costs £85 and a couture hat designed by Philip Ricci. Now, what do you think of this one, Alexandra?
Well, I can see her underwear too.
You can see her.
It must be an in thing, but I like that one. I like it.
I think that's very lovely.
The hat would be kind of fun.
The hat's good. Okay. Well, here we have Donna. She's wearing a dress made from delphiniums, scabious, hydrangeas, rose petals, and even thistles. Possibly a bit prickly, but Absolute Flowers, it's called. It costs you £350. And the hat is from Harold and Hearts, which is saying, oh, no hat! She's not wearing a hat. Okay, well, we'll get the hat. What do you think of that one, Alexandra?
Well, I mean, it's £350. Why do you think it's going to live, then?
It's not going to live very long.
Plus, what happens if the prince, if we're a guest of Prince Michael, okay, what happens if he's allergic to flowers?
They'll be sneezing. Well, we have our final outfit for you here, Alexandra. Let's welcome Joanne Guest. Jo Guest. What is she wearing? Well, this was designed by the Parisian fashion student, Hanny would set you back £350. Oh, no. It's made from metal, recycled cans.
Wow. Okay, I like that. Georgia. I like
the recycled cans. You like recycled cans?
Yeah.
Which dress do you think
well,
you could wear?
Being sort of a conservative girl myself, I think this one's my favourite.
Okay, you're going to say that's your favourite. Well, I'll tell you what, we're going to send you off. Bring on your escort. Is Jason there?
Jason?
Jason's got his outfit ready for Ascot as well. And we're going to send you off. We're going to send you off to try on these outfits, and we want to see it at the end of the show.
Yeah,
are you going to do it for us? Yeah. Go on, girls, take it away. Very soon. We will see Alexandra Paul in her chosen outfit right now. It's the final Big Breakfast News and Weather of the 1,000th show with Peter Smith. Yeah.
Closing headlines. Scientists are blaming cigarette smoke for most of Britain's 500 annual cot deaths. A two-year study shows that two-thirds of the victims could be saved if they were given a smoke-free environment. Divers have recovered both black boxes belonging to TWA Flight 800. The flight data and cockpit voice recorders are now being flown to Washington. It's hoped they'll solve the mystery of the ill-fated jumbo. Chemical giant ICI is set to axe 400 jobs across the UK. The company said the axe will fall by the end of next year. It's part of a package of worldwide job cuts that will see almost 3,000 disappear. Sean Connery could be back in the next James Bond film. The ex-007 has reportedly agreed to star in the latest instalment as the villain, but he'd want a massive £8 million to take on current super spy Pierce Brosnan. Now the weather, a warm sunny day in England and Wales with plenty of cool breezes, but expect rain over Scotland and Northern Ireland. Temperatures are climbing slightly to an average of 21 degrees centigrade. That's it from us. We'll see you tomorrow.
Hey, cheers very much. Thank you, Peter. Okay, the big moment.
A big
this
moment. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Are they ready?
She's not ready.
No,
well,
don't worry. A very big thank you to all our star guests here this morning, to Bob Geldof, to Nina, to Julia, to Gillian, to Cleo, to Tristan, a whole host of thousands of people.
It's time to shout. Where are you? Richard, Vanessa and Danny and the Ketteridge family.
We won this. We had a great time in Essex.
Here we go. As I look back in time, it's never meant to shift. I was meant for you, and you were meant for me. Since the day we met, had only us to see one another. No one else can compare. And looking back, I remember all the fun and games. What we got right now really hasn't changed. Cause we've always believed in what we had. So we did our best to make it last. Cause I have a love for you, unbreakable. I have a love for you so strong. Have a love for you that's so, so deep. Love you all along. Have a love for you, unbreakable. Many times I wondered how we get a love for life. But we got through some things, but lovers don't survive. Cause we've always believed in what we had, so we did.